हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। लेट्स स्टार्ट रीडिंग द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर नंबर 3 डीप वाटर व्हिच हैड बीन स्टार्टेड बाय अस इन द लास्ट लेक्चर। ओके, सो नाउ विद दैट दिस द पैसेज इज टू बी रेड बाय अस। विद दैट ही पिक्ड मी अप एंड टॉस्ड मी इनटू द डीप एंड आई लैंडेड इन ए सिटिंग पोजिशन स्वेलोड वाटर एंड वेंट एट वंस टू द बॉटम। I was frightened but not yet frightened out of my wits. On the way down I planned when my feet hit the bottom I would make a big jump, come to the surface, lie flat on it and paddle to the edge of the pool. What did you learn here? Bete, in this passage we are told that William Douglas made different two kinds of activities there. The first one, he went down directly to the bottom when he was thrown away into the deep end of the pool. Secondly, he made a very nice planning strategy. He also made a very good strategy to come out of the water body and be safe. With that, he picked me up. With that, speaking such words, speaking those words in connection with that question, that muscular bodied, strong bodied, very powerful young boy picked him up, picked William Douglas up into his arms and threw him away. Tossed means throw away. Okay. In circling, in swirling form, and tossed me into the deep end and threw him away into the deep end point of the YMCA pool. First of all, the young child picked William Douglas into his arms very safely, very tightly, and then he threw him away into the deep end. Okay, where the water was 9 feet deep. At that end, he threw him into the water. I landed in a sitting position. As soon as William Douglas was thrown away into the deep end point of the YMCA pool, he landed mean he went down. He went down to the bottom of the pool in a sitting position, swallowed water. He took some gulps of water through his mouth helplessly. He took some water into his body and went at once to the bottom. And he says that he, without wasting so much time, reached the bottom very soon, very immediately, because he was thrown into the water very forcefully. I was frightened. As soon as William Douglas went down to the bottom, and as soon as he arrived, he reached the level of the bottom. Okay. He got badly frightened, but not yet frightened out of my wits. Here we find out a very excellent quality which is being represented by this the statement. Through this statement he wants to tell us that though he had been badly frightened to the time situation, but he did not lose his confidence. His mind was working properly. He had not been so much frightened. Okay. He had not been so much frightened in his mental feelings, mental perceptions. Mentally he was alert, but emotionally and sentimentally he got frightened. On the way down, I planned. While going down to the bottom of the YMCA pool, William Douglas made a very nice strategy planning. When my feet hit the bottom, it was his strategy planning. while going down, while making his journey, okay, to that 9 feet deep pool, into that 9 feet deep water, towards the bottom, he made a very good strategy. So while going down to the bottom, he made a plan. He thought that when his feet touched the bottom, he would make a big jump. He at the same moment pushed himself out very forcibly. Throw himself out with great force. He would throw himself out with great force. Come to the surface according to his planning. Then he would come to the surface of the water, outer side, lie down on it. As soon as he come to the surface, he would lie down quite flat on the body of the water and paddle to the edge of the pool, and he would start paddling the water, beating the water very hard, thrashing the water with his legs, and reach to one edge of the pool and be safe. According to the planning as made by William Douglas, he first would touch his feet, okay, to the bottom. As soon as his feet touched the bottom, he would throw himself out the water body quite forcefully, applying his all force, come to the surface. Finding it that he had come to the surface, he would lie down on the surface quite flat, in flattened position. Then, thrashing the water with his legs, he would go to one end of the pool and be safe, come out of it. It was the planning. It seemed a long way down. Okay, while going down to the bottom of the pool, William Douglas felt that he had taken so much time and he had not reached the bottom. That the journey seemed a very long journey for him. Those 9 feet were more than 90. He also considered that though the 9 feet looked more like 90. Means that the 9 feet deep end of the pool looked 90 feet for William Douglas, because he had taken so much time while making his journey from the surface to the bottom, but he had not reached the bottom by that time. That's why he got badly frightened. And before I touched bottom, my lungs were ready to burst. By the time William Douglas touched his feet, the tiled floor or the bottom of the pool, his lungs had started aching. It means his lungs had almost got so much tired, he could not keep himself in struggling position, okay, in that great sheet of water. But when my feet hit bottom, I summoned all my strength, but as soon as his legs touched the tiled floor of the bottom, okay, he gathered. Summoned means gathered. He gathered all his strength and made what he had thought was a great spring upwards, and made the same activity. He made the same jump as he had already planned. According to his previously made plan, he took a high jump outside the body of the water, so that he could come to the surface very soon and be safe. I imagine I would bob to the surface like a cork. At the time when he made such kind of big jump, while remaining inside the water body, into the water, he had imagined something differently, but his imagination could not be fulfilled, realized by him. Because whatsoever jump he made, it showed no positive effect. Instead, I came up slowly. He had planned that as soon as he would make a big jump, as soon as he would throw himself out with great force, he would directly come to the surface very immediately and lie down on it and be safe. But according to his imagination, nothing happened. All went against his expectation. Instead, I came up slowly. Instead of coming to the surface very fastly, very immediately, very rapidly, he says that he came up to the surface very slowly, at the slow speed. I opened my eyes. He opened his eyes when he came to the surface. He also opened his eyes in order to see whether he could get some person's help there. And so nothing, turn the page, but water that had a dirty yellow tinge to it. He could not see anything outside the surface of the water, but a yellow colored water that had spread, that was flowing from one direction to another, that was moving in the form of the little ridges, waves, ridges or waves. Hear the word? Yellow tinge stands for a yellow colored. Light yellow colored water moving from one place to another, one direction to other direction. Dirty yellow. The word dirty stands for here, sandy, and you may say there, because the color of the water had also changed since he had already entered the water. He had been thrown there into the water very forcibly, and the dust particles had also got mixed into the water. That's why the color of the water had also got changed, and it looked very dirty at that time. So that the dirty yellow colored water appeared before his eyes when he opened his eyes, so he could only see the dirty yellowish colored water flowing just before his eyes from one end to another end, from one place to another place. I grew panicky. Looking at that, there was nobody to help him. He could hardly see anyone, for his assistance, to get somebody's assistance there in that difficult situation. So he says that I got panicky. The word panicky stands for frightened. He again got badly frightened. Finding not a single person there for his help, and getting no such kind of other additional help from any other sources, he again grew tensed, tension and stress grew more and more in his mind. He got badly frightened to see that time situation. I reached up as if to grab a rope. Grab means hold tightly. He also tried to He also tried to throw his hand out. Okay, as if he wanted to hold a rope very tightly, and my hands clutched only at water. When he spread his arms outside the water, he could get nothing. He could catch nothing except hold the water under his palm, under his hand. So he could only clutch means hold, catch tightly, catch strongly, powerfully. So he could only catch the water body. He could only catch the water by his hands very tightly and nothing else. So I reached up as if to grab a rope. Through this statement, he wants to say that while struggling with the water into its body, William Douglas, though he had almost come to the surface, so as soon as he came to the surface, he threw his hand outside the surface. Means he spread out his hands. He wanted to hold off a rope so that he could catch a rope there, and getting spot of the rope, he could come himself out of the water body. But instead of catching any kind of rope there, he finally caught the water by his hand, and he again got badly depressed. I was suffocating. At that time he felt so much difficulty in normal breathing, in taking normal breath. It means at that time he felt himself so much suffocating. The word suffocating means he found much difficulty in breathing. He could not breathe very well at that time. I tried to yell. When he found that his condition was becoming bad to worse, when William Douglas noticed that his condition was becoming bad to worse and it had been difficult for him to breathe very comfortably, so he tried to cry loudly. He tried to shout loudly. Yell means cry loudly, but no sound came out. But no sound came out from his throat. He could not speak any word. He could speak no word. He found himself totally helpless. Then my eyes and nose came out of the water. All of a sudden, he noticed that his eyes and his nose had come out of the water body, but not my mouth. But his mouth was still inside the water and he could not speak any word. I flailed at the surface of the water. When he could not keep his mouth out of the water's body, so he found himself totally in flattened position. He says here, through this statement, he tells us that he lay down. Okay? He lay down in flattened position at the surface of the water. As soon as he lay down, just like a flail machine, okay, as soon as he spread his body, at the surface of the water, he swallowed some more amount of water. Means he took some more amount of water into his body, and choked, and his mouth got choked. He could not speak, he could not utter any words. I tried to bring my legs up. While struggling with the water, okay, for the last few minutes, William Douglas tried his best to put his legs up, but they hung as dead weights, paralyzed and rigid. But he found that there was no movement in his legs. His legs did not make any kind of movement. They got paralyzed. They had become lifeless. Though the legs had not become lifeless, but he thought that his legs had also been fully drained of all the power and strength. And there was no left. There was no strength left in his legs. That's why he could not move them any longer. And he got badly. He got badly panicked to sit on. Okay. I tried to bring my legs up. He tried to raise his legs up so that he could beat the water. So without raising the legs, how it could be possible for William Douglas that he could throw the water away, he could paddle the water and swim into the pool? It could not be possible for him. So first of all, he tells, I flailed at the surface of the water. The word flail stands for here, lie down. Okay, lie down, resting the stomach on the surface of the water. So resting means putting his stomach at the surface of the water. He tried to raise his legs up so that he could move them and thresh the water. But instead of getting any kind of help from his legs, he noticed that his legs had become so much paralyzed and lifeless, and they had hung down, okay, totally in a lifeless position, in a lifeless condition. As dead weights means as if there had been no life in the legs. And rigid means solid. They had become fully solid. A great force was pulling me under. He noticed that a great force, a hidden unseen great force was pulling him, okay, towards the bottom. I screamed. He tried to scream out. He tried to get somebody's help by shouting loudly, but only the water heard me. But he says that his voice could not be heard by anyone except the water. I had started on the long journey back to the bottom of the pool. Again, being so much helpless, finding himself so much helpless, he again started the long journey back to the bottom of the pool, and he found himself totally sad and upset at that time. Better the rest of the part will be read by us in the next lecture. Thank you.